Iron is an essential trace mineral in our bodies. We talk about the three aspects of iron functions in our bodies, which are iron in blood and muscles, transporting oxygen to body cells throughout the bloodstream. Iron supports the immune system and helps make body protein and hormones. Iron is also part of the enzyme catalase, protecting body cells from oxidative damage. Iron in blood and muscles transport oxygen to body cells throughout the bloodstream. Iron is a principal constituent of blood as an essential part of hemoglobin in red blood cells. The red color of the blood comes from the substance of the iron complex, heme iron in the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the protein containing heme iron in the blood cells. Heme iron exists in two proteins, hemoglobin and myoglobin. In other words, the mineral iron exists in hemoglobin and myoglobin as a heme iron complex. About two-thirds of our body's iron is in hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the protein in our blood red cells, whereas myoglobin is the protein contained in muscles. The hemoglobin of the red blood cells in the bloodstream binds oxygen in the lungs, transports oxygen to body cells and carries carbon dioxide away from cells for elimination by the lungs. Myoglobin is a muscle protein providing oxygen to muscles for muscle contraction. Next, let's talk about iron helping make body proteins and supporting the immune system. Iron helps make body protein. For example, iron helps produce collagen. Collagen is a fibrous scleroprotein in bone, tendon, cartilage, and connective tissue. Collagen is the main structural protein in the extracellular matrix found in the body's various connective tissues. The human body also uses iron to make some hormones and connective tissue. For example, iron helps synthesize vitamin A by converting beta-carotene to vitamin A. Iron supports a healthy immune system. In addition, iron helps in brain development. Last, let's discuss iron as a part of the enzyme catalase, protecting our bodies from oxidative damage caused by free radicals in the body. The enzyme catalase protects the cells from oxidative damage. Catalase is an enzyme that destroys hydrogen peroxide into oxygen and water before the peroxide can damage the cells. Oxygen is essential for life, but oxygen can also be poisonous. Excessive oxygen in the body can induce the formation of free radicals, peroxides, and other reactive oxygen species, such as superoxide, hydroxyl radical, singlet oxygen, and alpha oxygen. These reactive oxygen species are highly reactive chemicals and can damage cells with an oxidation reaction. For example, peroxides are free radicals, which can damage cells through the oxidation of the cell components. Many trace elements interact with oxygen, some by assuring oxygen is delivered to cells and some by preventing oxidative damage. But unfortunately, minerals can also catalyze the formation of dangerous free radicals. To prevent the formation of free radicals, the body stores, transports, and uses these minerals in the forms of the protein complex. Therefore, these minerals cannot cause the formation of free radicals. For example, iron is transported in the body by binding the protein transferrin, and iron is stored in mucosal cells by forming a ferritin protein iron complex. The iron storage protein, ferritin, keep iron in a soluble and non-toxic form in the body. Ferritin is an intracellular protein that stores and releases iron in a controlled fashion, acting as a buffer against iron deficiency and overload. The iron transportation protein, transferrin, binds iron tightly but reversibly, mediating the iron transportation through blood plasma. Transferrins are produced in the liver and contain binding sites for two ferric ions. Sutasty made this video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.